The landslide dam, which completely blocked Canada's major Chilcotin River on July 31st, leaving it completely dry downstream, has just collapsed, resulting in a significant and damaging flood that has washed away entire buildings. This collapse began slowly at around 8 a.m. on August 5th, as the lake, which had been building in volume and height behind the dam, reached an elevation of 577 meters, 49 meters or 161 feet deeper than the river's typical level at its deepest point. This height marked the exact same height on the lowest part of the landslide dam, which happened to be on the river's northern bank, causing water to begin slowly advancing over it. As this occurred at around 8:50, part of the water began seeping into gaps in underlying landslide debris, which soon breached the eastern side of the landslide. Carrying heavy particulates and rock fragments, the lower channel continued to erode away at all sides until the top of the landslide deposit gave way. Then, the landslide breach continued to expand, going from releasing 500 cubic meters per second at 9:50 to 3,000 cubic meters per second of water at 12:30, equating to 12 times its normal volume this time of year, or 25% higher than the rate of water which flows through Niagara Falls. As a result, a flood watch was immediately upgraded to a flood warning along a 106-kilometer-long stretch of the Chilcotin and Fraser Rivers, all the way south to Big Bar Creek. Alongside this, 11 properties in the vicinity of Big Bar Creek were given evacuation alerts. While initial models suggested flood heights just to the east might reach 15 meters or 49 feet above the normal river level, geolocated footage seems to suggest the water level only reached up to 9 meters or 30 feet above the normal river level. As the floodwater scoured the riverbank, at 11:45 it reached an evacuated settlement, completely washing away 4 structures and entirely flooding a 5th building. At 12:20, the floodwaters reached another group of buildings, completely washing away 2 more structures and widening the riverbank there by 65 meters or 213 feet via a 5-meter high flood. At 12:27, the flood reached the Farwell Canyon Bridge, scouring the riverbank and ground surrounding its base. Even though this bridge has thankfully not collapsed, at least not yet, once this flood is over, it should be closed until it is determined to be structurally safe. By the time the floodwaters reached the confluence of the Fraser River, it had swept away thousands of tons of rock and sediment, along with tens of thousands of trees, forming a giant mass of debris which could cause problems further downstream. At 20:25, a 2.5-meter high flood reached the properties under the recently made evacuation alerts near Big Bar Creek. By the time this video is published, floodwaters, which are likely to have a maximum height slightly less than those shown in this graphic, are likely to have just reached Spuzum. At the landslide dam, by 2000 on August 5th, the floodwaters flowing east of the dam reduced from 3,000 to 1,800 cubic meters per second. These floodwaters are likely to continue to decline, but could remain elevated for as much as 12 to 24 hours depending on location once the initial floodwaters arrive. While 7 homes and buildings were likely destroyed, which is tragic, the flood, which is still ongoing, could have been a lot worse. I do have some new information revolving around why the landslide occurred in the first place, as apparently a medium-term cause of a major wildfire destroying vegetation on the slope in 2017 did not initiate the movement of the slope in question. While that could technically still have played a factor, the slope had been apparently already in motion at a slow rate for several decades beforehand. Also, supporting my previous notion that the landslide occurred in a region with multiple other young landslides whose dates we do not know, the indigenous peoples of the area call Farwell Canyon Nagweltled, which roughly translates to landslides across the river. As a final note, please keep away from the entirety of the Chilcotin and Fraser Rivers, which are under alerts, hence the flood warnings, flood watches, and high stream flow advisories currently in effect.